Hello everyone, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Will Warren, and today I want to show you guys the Rockwood Signature Ultra Lite 8312SS bunkhouse model. Rockwood is the number one selling fiberglass travel trailer in the entire nation, and that's for a few reasons. They have a great selection and they build great campers. They have high quality construction and they have the warranties to back it up as well. You have a 1 year bumper to bumper warranty, 2 year structure warranty, 2 year appliance warranty, 10 year axle warranty, a 3 year linoleum warranty, and a 12 year roof warranty. These guys stand behind their products. Now this model has a lot of features, so I'm really excited to show you what this is packed with. Now who doesn't love an outside kitchen? After all, you are camping, you wanna be outside, and you don't necessarily wanna have your bacon smelling up your entire camper. So they thought ahead of you with this model. So out here, we of course have our large outside kitchen. You have a two burner cooktop right here, and there's a propane line directly below on the underside, right where that yellow cap is, to connect to. And that feeds directly off your propane bottles. You also happen to have the sink. You do have hot and cold water out here. Little spice rack beside it. You got countertop space. You have storage for dry goods or plates, cups, whatever you want. You even have a microwave if you want to heat up some ramen noodles. You're a college student and you bought this camper. Wait, well, that doesn't actually make any sense. College students can't buy campers like this. At least I couldn't. You have an outside refrigerator right here. Now this is electric only. Nobody puts a gas electric refrigerator in outside kitchens just because they cost a lot more money than something this size. But you're plugged in with this. That'll cool all your drinks. You even have storage right here. Now when you're ready to go and fold this thing up, you simply put that away right there. This, if you're curious, is the end of your quick connect that easily plugs in right down there. And then you have, of course, the cover for it. You'll notice that it's actually kind of angled, and that's done on purpose, really, to help shed the water away, so that way it's not kind of just sitting on this thing while you're using it if it happened to start raining on you. There's slam latch handles, and there's slam latch throughout the entire coach, but of course, we can show you right here kind of how that works. You just pop that down, you're not sitting there twisting any knobs. Now, let me talk about some of the other features you see here. Now this is closed. So we have frameless windows throughout the entire coach, and there's two electric awnings. And I left this one here actually rolled up on purpose because I wanted to show you, you notice that it has a wrap of metal around it. And what that does is that protects that awning fabric from getting chewed up by the sun, especially here in Colorado. We're so high up that UV does a number on something like that. So that'll protect that. It'll also protect it from rain, snow, hail, all those things. Now there you can see that the awning is open over there. Now there's LED light strips underneath that awning right there. There's also a bug light. And then if we go further down, you'll see that there's two doors. So this is your rear door here. This wouldn't be your main access. This opens up to your bathroom. And let's say you really need to air out your bathroom for, you know, reasons. There's a screen door right here that you can leave open, and it'll help ventilate and provide a lot of light. So you can cook outside. You can also this outside. So there's also a radius door right here. Now that's important. If this awning were out, and let's say you kind of had it angled, pitched a certain way to help shed water, which they do just like this. So when you pitch that, sometimes it might come in contact with this door right here. Now that radius, that curve on that door doesn't have a sharp corner to it. So you're not gonna cut it if you were to open this door and it had a, you know, sharp 90 degree angle on it. You have a triple step entry into the bathroom as you do on the other entrance as well, and a large grab handle, and that's really nice getting in and out of the coach, especially if it was to start raining on you and if these steps just got a little slick, you know, that can prevent a little bit of injury there. Now over here, gosh, there's a lot to talk about on this coach. Okay, you have your double axle configuration. Now these axles are torsion suspended. So what does that mean? What is a torsion axle? Well, normally there's a leaf spring set up on each axle that provides the suspension. The only problem with that is that it's not independent. So the torsion axle system is independent. Each wheel has its own independent suspension from the others. So what that means is if you're driving on uneven road, and let's say this side of the road is higher, you're not gonna kinda go, they're not gonna be moving together up. Instead, you're gonna have one wheel going up and the other one is, they're both making even contact with the ground. So it means a much nicer pull down the road, especially in uncertain road conditions. They're also aluminum rimmed as well. Now, aluminum doesn't rust out like steel does, and it also dissipates heat. You can also easily re-lube these axles. They have a quick lube port, so you can plug in and re-lube them really fast if you need to. And then let's just come on up and talk about some of the stuff we have here. This is a TV bracket. So this unit does come equipped with a main TV in the living room area. If you want to, you can detach that, bring it out here and slide it into the bracket right there. There's also a cable outlet that you can plug into if you want to watch cable out here. And there's power right here. There's two GFI outlets. So if you want to run your TV, or let's say you just want to hang up some Christmas lights, because that does look really cool, let's be honest, you can do that right from here. Now up there, you see those two round black speakers. So there's a media center inside the living room area of the coach, and you can play your tunes out here. As a matter of fact, it's Bluetooth compatible, so if you're like me and you keep all your music on your phone, you can sync it up to the Bluetooth player and then turn on the outside speakers and control all the tunes here while you're making breakfast at your outside kitchen. Now you may be asking yourself, where's the barbecue on the outside kitchen? Well, they couldn't fit it all in there, so it's just right here. This little bar right here allows for a bracket to connect to that, and then you slide the grill onto that bracket. Then all you gotta do is plug the grill into your propane quick connect, and you got propane then feeding from your bottles to the grill, and you can start grilling away. So we can put that back up. And then as we're moving down here, this is your hot water heater. So you got a 6 gallon gas electric DSI hot water heater. So it has a lot of advantage compared to the old school hot water heaters RVs used to come with. You don't have to light it yourself. You just flip a switch, it'll light itself. Also, if you're plugged in, it can be heated on electricity versus using your propane. If you're not plugged in, you can use your propane since you don't have electric power. And it recovers at 16.2 gallons per hour when you are plugged into electricity. So it's a very quick recovery rate and very easy to use compared to the old style. Now here's our main entry door. Again, we got a large grab handle. We got a 3-entry step. And then I forgot to mention this earlier on the doors. They have these friction hinges. So they kind of stay put wherever you put them. And that's really nice, because if the wind were to kick up on you really quick and you happen to have this door open, it's not gonna violently slam shut like a lot of others used to that didn't have any resistance on the hinge whatsoever. And then we can move on down here. We got more frameless windows. The awning extends all the way to here. So if you look at this coach is about 35 feet in length. You're only missing about 4 foot, not even 3 foot of space versus you got a ton of shade on this side of the coach. Now, you also have storage too. And I want to mention a couple things. Look at the size, the thickness of this storage door right here. So this storage door is awfully thick. They have core foam insulation in this, just like you do in your walls. And of course that helps to insulate your coach. Now also you may be noticing that there's this round thing right here. That's actually a magnet. So all of these now have magnets to hold your door open. You're no longer breaking those little plastic latches that they used to come with. So this storage goes all the way through. You can see up here, this is the aluminum framework that Rockwood uses. The entire coach is framed out in aluminum. It's not framed out in wood. And it's also welded at each joint with two welds. Some guys, they'll kind of be cheap on that. They'll use one weld. Well, as you can imagine, that's kind of like taking a paper clip and bending it back and forth and back and forth and back and forth over time. It's gonna eventually get brittle and crack on you. Now right here is your control for your electric jacks. There's electric jacks in the back and also the front. And it's push button. So with the push of a button, you can extend the jacks and you can also retract them. And below all of this is this little black plug here. This coach is already prepped for solar power. So if you want to charge your batteries on a solar panel, you can do that very easily. These little suitcase panels you can buy, they have a built-in controller. You simply set them out in the sun and you plug them directly into this right here and you're automatically charging your batteries. Now there's a lot to talk about on the front of the 8312 as well. So here we have a full wraparound cap. So it wraps around the sides of the unit, and of course that prevents leaking. And it's also extremely tough. You can take a sledgehammer to this part right here and it's not gonna crack on you. There's even a rhino lined lower quarter of the front cap. And that's designed, of course, to take abuse from any rocks that maybe your tow vehicle kicks up. Now you got the large front window as well. That's something that a lot of guys are not doing. This is automotive glass, just like you would have on your vehicle as well. So it lets in a lot of light. And of course there's blinds on the other side if you want to kind of block that out. You have two 30 pound propane tanks with an automatic crossover. So if one runs dry, it'll flip over to the next. You have your electric tongue jack right here. This has an LED light on the front, so it makes it easy to connect and disconnect if it's dark outside. And of course, with a push of a button, you can raise or lower this unit. Now, over here, there's your battery box where normally this battery would be sitting, but just for convenience, we have it out. And there's also a battery disconnect located right under those bottles there. So when you go to store a coach, there are things that are gonna constantly be pulling power off your battery, your propane detector and your smoke detector. Those never stop because they're safety related items. But if there's nobody in the coach and you're just storing it for a month or two, you'll wanna disconnect that battery disconnect. And what that does is it kills all power in the coach, even to those permanent items, those safety related items. And that keeps your battery fresher for longer. And then this coach, let's talk about the weight of this coach, right? You've got two slides, and again, it's pretty long. It's about 34 feet in length. So this coach weighs 7829 pounds, and that's a dry weight. So without any water in it, no gear, no propane, it's 7829. Now that's one weight, right? There's two weights you need when you're talking trailers, the dry weight and then the GVWR. Your GVWR for the coach is 8,970 pounds. So what is the difference between those two numbers? Well, the GVWR is the weight rating of the axles. That says, with the weight of the trailer plus cargo, these axles can handle up to 8,970 pounds. So that gives you your cargo carrying capacity. So this has quite a bit of cargo capacity. Let me just double check here. We were at 7829. 9870. So you got 1,000 pounds of cargo. And that's gonna be more than enough to cover your water and your gear and all that stuff. They say, water's gonna be about 300 pounds. And then the rest of your gear, you won't get close to that. Now here we also have the other door to the pass-through storage. More frameless windows. And our slide out. Let's continue to the back. I want to show you where the hookups are. Now here we are at the main slide of the unit. There's your power cord in this bag right here. It is a 50 amp cord because this unit does have the option of a second AC. Obviously storage underneath the dinette area. Slam latch handles again. Thick baggage door for insulation. And then we have some of our connections on this side here. So the black, this black connection port right here is for your cable and satellite. So this is for your cable if you're at a campground with cable access. This is for satellite if you happen to have a portable satellite you want to connect to. And then down here, this is where you would connect your 50 amp cord. Now again, this unit does have the option for a second AC. We only put one on it because it's Colorado and usually people are more concerned with heat than rather than cold. But if you want it, you can easily put it on. Now there's also a nice feature on this, and that is this little green light right here. If you plug it in a campsite and you see this green light turn on, that means that you are getting power from your pedestal to the coach. If you plug in and there's no green light on, that means you're not getting power through your cord. So there could be a couple things going on. You know, there could be, maybe you didn't screw it in quite all the way, or maybe you need to flip the breaker over on your pedestal to get power to it, but that's there just to kind of help you troubleshoot if you don't have power in your coach. Also, I just want to mention real quick, up here, there's another flood lamp right there. And that's because you happen to have your dump valves down below. So if you're dumping this at night, you want to have light. So here's where you connect your sewer hose. This is your gray valve, which of course is the smaller of the two pipes. And then your black valve's over there, and that's the larger of the two pipes. Your black tank is for toilet waste, and your gray tank is for sink and shower water. So here we are at the back of the 8312. I wanted to kind of talk about some of the stuff you're going to see at the top and work our way down. So you notice that the roof is curved. So all the roofs on the Rockwoods are radius, meaning that they have that curvature to them. And that's designed, of course, to help shed water. You'll also notice that at each corner of the roof, there's these little black spigots. Now, if you can imagine, if your coach has been out for a while, the roof has gotten dusty, and then you have a rainstorm. Well, as that water starts to shed off the roof, it's going to be pretty black from all of that dust accumulating up on the top. Those are designed to kick the water out away from your coach. That way you don't have these nasty black streaks running down the side. Now, there's also a black box right below those three red running lights. Now, that is prep for a backup camera. So it's already prepped for a Furion backup camera system. So if you want to have a backup camera on this, you just purchase the camera, purchase the screen that comes with it, and then we take out the dummy plug in there, plug it in place, you sync that wirelessly to the screen that it came with, and you take that screen into your tow vehicle. And as long as you have your running lights turned on, there's power to the camera, and you can see what's going on behind the coach. It's really great for backing up. And obviously we have a frameless window right here. This is actually to the bunk room. And then I love this on the spare tire. So the spare tire is not that all exciting, but this little plastic thing is. Because sometimes the covers that they give you are the fabric, and those are okay, but they typically wear out after maybe 2 years or so. They start to crack from the sun exposure, and you have to replace it with a new one. This one is gonna last you a much, much longer time. I mean, it could potentially last the full life of the coach. Now, right here is your outside shower. So there's hot water, cold water, and you can just pull this out, shower yourself off of your Sandy, shower your kids off, shower your dogs off, whatever. And one thing I like about RV shower heads is that once you get the temperature right, you can cut off the water supply just by going like this. That way you don't have to keep finding that sweet spot on the temperature all day long while you're showering. Now this folds up neatly by just kind of wrapping the hose around your hot and cold valves, and it latches in place like that. Now here, let me lock this in place real quick so it's not in our way. 751 key, and there you go. Now down below is your water connections. So you'll notice that there's a diagram here showing you what's going on and what everything is. So this right here is your tank flush. So when you go to dump those black tanks we were showing you earlier, you can hook a hose to this that helps to flush those out. And it prevents, you know, of course, any smells from building up inside your coach. And then this is where you would connect your city water line to. So if you want to, if you have a connection at a campground for city water, you plug directly into this and you leave this little blue knob pointed down. And that means that it's gonna operate, the whole coach is gonna operate off of the pressurized water coming through the hose. Now, if you're ready to winterize, you simply flip this blue line so it's pointing to the driver's side of the coach, and then you can plug your hose into this and put the other end into a bottle of antifreeze, and you can suck that through your whole system to winterize your coach. Now, right here is your water tank fill for, well, your water tank. So if you're gonna be camping without city water connection, you'd fill up your water tank to the brim, and then when you get to where you're going and you want to have water, you simply turn on your water pump, and that'll pressurize your water system so you can have both hot and cold water. And lastly, let me point out two more things. You have your control for the jacks here on the rear end, and then you have your ladder, and that's of course to allow you to get up on the roof. You generally want to condition these roofs maybe once every 6 months, and if you need to do any maintenance up there, this will give you access as well. Hey guys, come on in, let me show you the inside of this 8312. Alright, now toward the front of the coach, we have the bedroom, so let's start there first. Come on in over here. First thing I want to show you real quick is you have two actual doors, not just a curtain. So these are held in place by, again, magnets. It's very convenient. And when you're ready to drive down the road, they have these latches right here to keep them from banging all over the place. Now you can also take your TV that's in the front room, and you could also move it to the bedroom if you want to, or if you want to have a permanent TV, you could do that as well. It simply slides into this bracket here. There's a cable connection. There's also a satellite connector as well. So if you have a portable satellite, you can use this to get that in here. And of course, an outlet. Now, the bedroom has a queen bed. There's storage underneath. We can lift it up and show you real quick. So there's drawers. And you notice it's framed out in aluminum. Again, that's how Rockwood does all their construction in their coach. There's that gigantic window that we showed you outside that's obviously covered up right there. It's the nice pleated shades. They happen to be day-night shades. So what that is right now, this is what you call the night shade. And if you want a little more light, you open this up and you have a day shade, just to let in a little bit of light but make it softer. You also happen to have in the bedroom two wardrobes on each side. One there and one here, plus storage above. There's LED lights throughout the whole coach, so you got reading lamps, you have your main lights in the bedroom, and then over on that side of the coach, you notice you have a charging center and a GFI outlet. So you can use that to plug in your phone, plug in your tablet. If you have a CPAP machine, you could use it to do that. There's also drawers on each side as well. And those also do kind of self-close or soft-close drawer. So let's go over here into the living room. Let's see what features there are in here. Okay, now this coach does come with a TV. We've taken it out of it for now. We usually do that for our new coaches, but it mounts right here. It really does fill up the space very well. You also happen to have your media center right here. This will control your radio, DVDs, CDs, all those things. It's also Bluetooth compatible, so if you want to hook up your Bluetooth, you can do that as well. There's storage down below. Obviously, you have a shelf here, little cupboard space there. And then this is double hinged to give you access to, I believe it's part of the furnace system right down there. So if you need to access that, you can get in there and do that as well. There's also obviously going to be storage up here too. And here's part of your speaker system. So you have surround sound in the coach. It's a 5-point speaker system. And this does pivot and swivel. So in case if you want to watch it on the couch, you can do that easily without having to crane your neck. And speaking of the couch, so right here, we obviously have the couch. Now, you can take these off and transform this into more sleeping. So, as a matter of fact, this coach has a ton of sleeping room. You can sleep two people here very easily. It simply folds up like this, extend the two legs, fold that down. So you got two people here, you can sleep two people on the dinette, you can sleep three people in the back room. So you got 4, 7, 9 people you can sleep easily inside this coach. And when you're ready to fold this back up, you just lift up that back portion there. Make sure you fold in your legs. And then put back your two cushions. Another thing I like is they give you the storage above the couch. They also give you these directional lamps, which are kind of nice. So if you like to read books, you can. Everybody else has gone to bed and you're up reading, you can flip that on without blinding everybody around you. Of course, you still have overhead lights on both sides of the slide out. You have windows on each side. Now the windows, of course, all open. The side windows though, they open by going straight up, and for good reason too. So there, that one is open. Now, what you wouldn't want to have is you wouldn't want to have this style of window right here. So that's nice, it can stay open during the rain, you can still get fresh air. This one you might want to close while it's raining, but you can imagine that if this window kind of kicked out like that does, and you brought in your slide, forgot to closing up that window, you could do some serious damage. But most guys don't give you windows all throughout the entire slide out. You might have one, you might have two, but you rarely get a window on each end of the slide as well. Now I want to show you the kitchen of the 8312. We've gone ahead and set up the little countertop extension here for you. So you, when you get ready to use this, of course, you'll just remove this protective plastic sheet, but it hooks on the end here, and then you have the leg that kind of pops it up for you and keeps it nice and level. You'll notice that this has Corian countertops throughout the entire kitchen area. So you have some space here for some appliances. You happen to have a plug up above to make it very easy to plug into as well. And then there's your sink. So you have the two compartment stainless steel, which is really nice. A lot of guys are still doing a plastic sink, but in the Signature series, you get upgraded to the stainless, which is really nice. And of course, these sink covers here act as a, additional countertop space. Now you see over here, you happen to have some pass-through storage. And then you obviously have your microwave, your range hood, and then they make a flush range cover for you as well, just to increase your counter space. And when it's time to cook, you can fold this up like that, and you have your backsplash. And of course, you have your propane oven down below. This is the 21 cubic inch oven, so it's a 21 cubic inch oven, so it's much more deep and bigger than your typical RV oven as well. And then this right here is a spot where you can store some scrubbies for washing dishes. And you have three drawers here as well. So they're ball bearing metal glides, and they're also self-closing, which is why they're kind of tough at first. And they're designed to be tough to pull out at first too. That way you don't have stuff just automatically flying out at you as you're driving down the road. And one of the best features of this kitchen is by far the fridge. It's just still a gas electric refrigerator, but this happens to be 9 cubic foot instead of 6. And you can see the difference when you finally fully open it. So you got a ton of space in this fridge, which is really good if you're gonna be probably camping with a bunch of kiddos in this unit as well. Now down below the fridge, this is your fuse and breaker box. So if you had a fuse go out, you could replace it here. If you had a breaker trip, you could flip it there to get it back up and running. That's your propane detector in case you're curious. And then right here, this is a heat register. So there's floor ducted heat throughout the entire coach. And then directly above me is the AC. There's AC ducted throughout the entire ceiling of the coach as well. There's always two ducts too. A lot of guys will just give you one every so many feet, but on a Rockwood, there's always two for however many feet they can go. Now, if it was really hot in here like it is today, it's hot and humid, and I had the power, I would turn on this AC. And I wouldn't just let it go throughout the ductwork system. First, what I would do is I would open up these vents. This is called the quick cool feature. So this allows all the air to quickly dump out of the AC and cool off the place in a hurry. And then once you get to a temperature that you're comfortable with, you can close those up and it'll evenly be distributed throughout the entire coach. Now, right here you have your thermostat. This will control the AC and it'll also control the furnace. And again, if you decide to install a second AC in the unit, you can even control the zones because there will be two separate zones for the air conditioner as well. Now, if you guys are ready, let me take you into the bathroom and show you what's in here. Okay, so here you have a tub, and that's kind of important. When you're talking about a bunkhouse model, something that's really good with kids, you might want to have a tub if you have smaller kids. And it also has a nice screen that closes shut, so you don't have to worry about getting the floor soaked. Now you have the stone cast sink right here, and you notice this basin is very large, which is nice. A lot of times the sinks they give you in the bathrooms are super small. You also happen to have your medicine cabinet and mirror. You have a GFI outlet right here again, and you have more storage down below. There's even this little black box right down here And that's designed to give you access in case you ever have to work on the plumbing. You can open that up and easily get underneath the tub basin, which is a rarity in a coach. Now directly above me is one of the things I'm most thankful for right now, and that is this high-powered RV fan. So it's actually called a fantastic fan. It moves about 920 cubic feet of air per minute. So when you flip it on all the way like we have it on right now, it acts like a whole house fan, pulling the air through the whole unit, kind of circulating it for you. Also, of course, very good for removing any smells in the bathroom, as well as, of course, remember you do have your screen door as well that you can leave open too. Now directly behind me, you got great linen storage. Really tall, goes, you could put a ton of stuff in there. And then the toilet in this is a porcelain toilet. So it's not a cheap plastic sink, or not a cheap plastic toilet. There's also a heat vent in here, and I point that out because sometimes RV manufacturers will try to skimp on you and they won't put a heat register in the bathroom, and so you have like a frozen throne that you get to sit on, which is never pleasant. Now before we go back here to the bunk room, the kids area, I wanted to show you this last closet. So this could be one of two things. Well, you got a shelf up here, and that's permanent. But down here you have this bar and then more shelves. These shelves, however, can be removed. So if you want to use this as more wardrobe space, you can do that. What I would most likely recommend to folks is to take out these to leave the shelves in place and use it as a pantry space, because that is a lot of pantry space and you already have two wardrobes up there and you have a ton of other closet space available. And as a matter of fact, you even have more closet space back here, which let me show you real quick. So here you got more cupboards. You can remove these again. You can even install another bar right here if you wanted more hanging space. This is a little ladder that of course helps kids get up to the top bunk right here. They have AC back here as well. You notice they even have their own speaker system back here. And then here you got more shelving as well. Now, we don't option in the TV for the bunk room because, let's be honest, you're going camping, kids. You're not supposed to be watching TV. You're supposed to be outside digging in the dirt and eating worms and fishing and stuff. So, but if you really want to and it's a rainy day, I suppose mom and dad could be nice enough to buy you a TV, and you could bring your Switch, of course, because it's portable. It's not like I want one or anything, and you could play your video games down here. You could also, of course, use this to listen to the radio as well. A spot for your Switch, let's say, and then right down here, more storage. Now, I said you could sleep three people back here, but you may have noticed there's only two bunks. So this nice thing is this couch right here. So this couch, just like the one you saw previously, can be transformed into another bunk. So in actuality, you could really sleep up to four people back here, one there, and then two people on the couch. So if you have a taller kid, the couch is the perfect way to go for them, because these are really more for your smaller kids, like my two girls. But as they get older, they could transition to this. Now, if you were here watching TV on a rainy day and not being outside, you can also lift up the bunk bed there so you're not bonking your head while you're sitting here watching TV. Now there's a window right by this bunk. You can see right there. There's also one over there for cross breeze. Then you do happen to have another vent up here which you can open up just to get some more ventilation. Oh, that feels really good. And then back here we have more day-night shades. And you have, of course, there's always emergency exits throughout the entire coach. This is another one of them. But you can still use this, just push it open, leave it that way to get more ventilation as well. And also, if your kids need to charge their devices, because of course every kid has their device now, you have another outlet right down here and an outlet right there. So nobody will go deviceless. Thank you for watching our video on the Rockwood 8312SS. I know it's long, but there's a lot of stuff to go through on this coach. If you guys enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to our channel. Our cameraman Octavio, he's amazing. He puts up content all the time for us, so there's always something new to watch. And if you'd like to be alerted as to when he uploads those new videos, hit that bell button, and of course you'll be alerted to when we upload our new content. If you had any questions, feel free to leave a comment. We do actually reply to them. He'll grab whoever did the video and we'll actually directly reply to you. If you want to talk to us a little more directly, you can always email us. You can email us at sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or you could also give us a call at 970-313-4337. And if you're interested in seeing more of our product, more pictures and specifications on this unit or any others we have in stock, you can visit our website at www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. Thank you very much for watching, and we hope to see you next time.